Good morning, everyone. It's Mark from Ford Mustang 98 Guy, and today we are going to take a full in-depth walk around look at the 2003 Mercedes Benz E320. This morning, I'm going to give you all a full in-depth tour and walk around of the Mercedes E320. I'm going to start it up. I'm also going to show the engine, and I'm going to show you all the inside as well as the outside of the car. Now we're doing a recall, or say I'm redoing the video here, because as you can see, I'm going to try and do a better job this time, because last time you may notice the car was a little dirty. So let's hope this time we get a better video out of it. So without further ado, we'll sit inside, start it up, let it run. Gonna unlock the car. I got some cars coming by, so ignore that. And here goes the key fob. It's like a laser key. The color of the exterior is kind of like a mix of a beige and champagne, or sort of something like a beige champagne color. It's like a teal color. You have black leather interior. The car has 159,000 kilometers, which is really low kilometers for a 13-year-old car. That's actually not bad for a 2003. And this time, and as you can see, I just have the key fob. So remember last time I had all those keys dangling around, so I'm going to try and do a better job. I'm going to take the old video off YouTube and put this one up as a refresh. So let's take the key and we'll start the engine. And the car starts right up. I'm gonna put the window down, close the door. I'm sorry about the cars coming by, it's just cars on the road, that's the problem. But it doesn't bother me. You get a full leather wrapped steering wheel. Very easy to turn. I believe this is a 5-speed or 6-speed automatic transmission. You have manual shift mode as well. You can even shift the vehicle manually if you want. It's also covered in wood grain up here. Very nice. Emergency brakes located down there. With the brake release. So we'll keep that on for safety. Not bad. Actually, no, I'll just take it off. It's not gonna go anywhere anyways. So let's turn on the automatic headlights, front and rear fog lights, as well as the hazards. Unlock the rest of the doors. Let's check out the outside. These are not the factory rims from Mercedes. These are actually aftermarket. The brand is called Fast. It's got the snow tires on at the moment. So let's open the hood. Where's the hood release? It would be down here. I like the way the car's parked, it's a little bit off. Anyways, let's check out the engine. So this is a 3.2 liter V6, or actually, my bad, 3.2 liter inline six. Like I mentioned, it's a 3.2 liter inline six cylinder. It's a very good engine too. Let's close the hood. Do a review on the inside. Yeah, if we can. Due to the stupid cars passing by. Off to this side, you have your power windows, you have your window lock. You have a three person memory for the driver's seat. You also have power seats as well. Power mirrors. You also have wood grain across. Storage down there. I'll show you how the power seats work. As you can see, it's sliding. Slide back. And I'll show you. That works. You got more storage in there underneath the seat. You also have a power telescoping steering wheel. And it's also heated as well. You also have a heated steering wheel as well. The switch would be right here. You just turn that and it's on. And you also have a power telescoping steering wheel. I'll show you that. Goes in and out, goes up and down. Pretty nifty. All right. So now, let's give her a few revs. One's okay. Very good. Alright. I do have a 2006 Mercedes Benz E-350 on my channel if you want to check that one out. That one there has the 3.5 liter inline six cylinder. So it was a silver in color, and you can check that one out. It's almost identical to this one. This is an E-320. Your dual zone automatic climate control is up there, along with your fan speed. You have different zones. You just move this little knob. Same on this side. You also have one touch automatic. You have temperature on each side. You can adjust it. You can adjust the temperature if you want. Let's turn that down a little bit. You have front defrost, as well as rear defrost. Different, as you can see. You can change it in between. Pretty nifty. And you have your circulation. Let's turn it. Actually, we'll just keep it on. Your air vents are up there. AM FM radio with CD player as well.
That's coming up on day six. Today, he wrote fake news, then it went viral.
There was nothing that was too absurd.
How satire became propaganda. The deadly risk of
I'm not sure what this does. You also have wood grain across the dash as well, as you can see. Goes all the way around.
School and underdogs on ice.
I believe that Jamaica can win an Olympic bobsled medal.
The Jamaican
down here.
Team returns to Canada. All today on day six.
You have your cigarette lighter or power outlet. You have some storage down there.
There will be no more churches,
pretty nifty.
Mosques, synagogues, or temples
up
on
here.
Bernard Street in Montreal.
This would come up.
Residents of Outremont
voted. And you have some storage back there.
New places of worship anywhere along Bernard Street, one of the main commercial streets.
You have some storage back there.
The bylaw will apply to all.
Push that button, goes back down.
One group in particular says they're
one more
being
time.
Unfairly targeted. For decades, Outremont has been home to a large and growing.
Push the button again, it goes back in.
Nearly one quarter of the neighborhood's residents are Jewish.
You also have three stage heated seats
in December 2015
for the driver and passenger.
A few months after they were granted a permit to build a new synagogue on Bernard.
Up out.
And it comes after a number of high profile anti-Semitic incidents across Canada, Europe, and
more storage in there.
The band supporters say the bylaws needed to protect commercial and business.
And this is your cup holder.
Other main thoroughfare.
Cup holder does work, but sometimes I can't do it with one hand.
But the Hasidic community.
Yeah, the cup holder is a little bit off the track.
Anywhere to build. This isn't the first time that
he can. Yeah, well, the cup holder has a hard time coming up.
Has come into conflict with the Hasidic community.
I won't be able to get that up, so. It does work. The cup holder works, but.
But my next guess is
it's not going to come up, so. Can't really show you the cup holder. You know, the 13-year-old car, it's going to have its issues.
Max, good morning. Welcome to the program.
Good morning.
Radio controls. You have a Bluetooth telephone as well. This is your drive information center.
Because they were unfortunately lured by a small
digital speedometer
that were able to create smoke screen. That this is about revitalizing commercial streets, and they did not know the reality that all this is about pushing out the Orthodox Jewish community.
Pretty nifty.
Were you hopeful that
off to this side, your wiper control?
That you could win the referendum?
We tried through the whole process. We went to the city council.
You have low speed right there. And high speed.
If they can get an independent study to prove that many synagogues and commercial streets.
Your turn signals.
Revitalize the street. But they refused to negotiate, to have any dialogue, or to produce any studies confirming this argument.
So you think
so the turn signals will be off to this side?
Is actually synagogues, and as you said in your answer to the first question, the Jewish community.
Pretty nifty.
A ban that covers all places of worship. Why do you think your community is the target here?
First off, the Jewish community is 25.
The light's supposed to come on, but I think this is a light, but it's not coming on for some reason. I'm not too sure if that's a light or not. And this becomes as a two-way process. Put that out. Next to sunshade. Neat option to have. It's a good feature to have back in 2003.
And when there was a request in 2014.
Coming up to your small cluster, you have your analog clock. Digital gas gauge will be right there. Speedometer in the center. In the middle is your speedometer. Your tachometer off to the right, and engine temperature gauge will be right there. Tell you how hot or cold the engine is.
On Bernard for an Hebrew synagogue, and that's what the city followed up with a ban on commercial streets.
Manually dimming rearview mirror? Okay. Or no, actually, my bad. Automatic dimming rearview mirror. It's not manually dimming, it's actually automatic dimming rearview mirror. So, my bad. And up here.
You have 25% of a borough, and it's growing.
Interior, you have your interior lights?
They will need new synagogues, and at the moment, there's not one. There's not one new place in Utrema that you can go.
Oh, you have to turn it on like that. There we go. And it goes off. And that's for the back.
And business owners in the neighborhood have argued that this is not about religion, but it is about protecting their commercial.
It works. Yes, a full power sliding sunroof as well.
And he spearheaded the Yes campaign for this week's referendum. Here's what he told us about the ban. We'll listen to this and then we'll come back.
We'll just leave it open for this case because it's shut the climate control off.
And if we have more and more of
get some air inside,
then this will have an impact on the new stores and new commerce.
People, this is a nice car.
Thinking of that this is unique because
it didn't come with navigation, though. It doesn't have that screen. It's just this is the radio.
No, we have nothing against.
That's not a bad car. Nice. So, let's put that window back down. Check out the back seat.
Daniel Major's argument. He says that this is a business decision because the synagogue should hurt business interests.
I think this is an insult to the intellect of the listener. This type of people, we don't want to integrate.
I'll sit on the other side.
This is the argument of revitalizing tomorrow. And we said, prove it to us. Get an independent study to say that this will help. Even Van Horn, there was a bin of Van since 1990.
Get some storage there.
Is Van Horn there?
And your cup holders, which have to be cleaned out.
Synagogue would harm commercial streets.
We'll show you the door sill.
I want to play you another clip from Daniel Major. Let's listen to this, then we'll speak again.
Sean?
Pretty nifty. Comes up pretty quick when you open it. Gas cap. Takes premium fuel. Takes premium fuel only, as you can see. So to open it, you just go like this. We'll sit on the back seat here. Wood grain as well. Same on that side. Let's sit in the back seat. Because it was a little bit tight on the driver's side because I had the seat all the way back. You also have climate control for the back as well. You can also, well, it's got to be on the front. You can control the temperature as well. But I don't think it's on right now, so you gotta have it on in the front, I think. Yeah, this is a little bit broken. Not a common issue with these Mercedes.
So to the notion that if they disagree on something, you can use the force of the law, that is not democracy. Second of all, the community does integrate. And the community does maybe, and we can. We this is one of our postmortems, is to do more outreach, and we're ready to do that.
Supposed to come on, but
change in our community. For example, in our schools, our younger children.
Ocean handle.
The older generation.
Sit him off to that side.
What they are asking is similar. That's the negative.
So same deal off to this side.
Conversation about religious accommodation within
this issue is not
to Quebec. This issue is
a power seats do work as they should.
The General of New York has sued the city of Port Jervis, where the city of Port Jervis has banned commercial speed.
Plus of wood grain.
So this is a worldwide phenomenon.
Storage down there. Sit inside. And this car is fully loaded. It's got everything. Got all the bells and whistles.
This should never happen.
Do you think that the U.S. election had an effect on the referendum that was held on Sunday?
No, I wouldn't say so. This is something that has been... There's a small group of instigators that is using...
that is using the majority to turn them against them. There's some insecurity, there's the unknown of other... And they,
love
this
box.
Small group of instigators is using here the 1,500 voters, which I strongly believe...
Same deal, same process on this side.
The truth is that this bylaw is about...
Extra sunshade.
If
you got extra sun in your eyes.
Prime Minister is riding, Justin Trudeau's riding is adjacent to yours. The Prime Minister is in Houston, New Jersey.
Oh boy. Alright, let's close up the roof.
Lawyers have said that you might have grounds for a constitutional challenge. Do you plan to take it to the Supreme Court next?
First, we'll take it to the Superior Court here in Quebec.
Alrighty.
The
window back up.
Two opinions that says this is, goes against the Constitution and Charter of Rights.
And how do you think that will sit if there's a judicial imposition?
Let's shut it down. Well, everyone, hope you guys enjoyed the full in-depth tour and walk around of the 2003 Mercedes Benz E320. Stay tuned for my next video. We'll see you next time. Take care and have a great day. And this time I did a great job, hopefully this time. And this time it turned out better. Don't worry about the winter tires. But anyways, did a great job so far. So let's lock it up and have a great day.